Here it is, the 512 gigabyte version of the Galaxy Z Fold 3 in Phantom Black. We're gonna do a quick unboxing, then I'm gonna show you guys the fastest way to set this up, regardless of whether you're transferring from another Samsung device, a non-Samsung Android device, or an iPhone. As always, there will be time codes down in the description so you can quickly jump around to the parts you care most about. If you guys appreciate video time codes, let me know by dropping a like down below. The first thing you'll notice is just how thin the box is, because it doesn't come with as much in the box compared to the Galaxy Z Fold 2. Opening the box, the first thing you see is the Fold 3 itself, and there's a little pull tab here. I'm gonna go ahead and take this out and set this to the side. Beneath that, you get a little box, and if you pull that box out, in here you get your USB-C to USB-C cable and a little bit of documentation. Flipping the box over, you get your SIM ejector tool. Let's go ahead and set this to the side. We're gonna need that in a minute. And that's it. So you can see you don't get wired headphones or a charger in the box. And if you don't already have a fast charger from a previous device, then I highly recommend just sticking with Samsung's 25 watt charger. You can get other 25 watt chargers, but unless they have a technology called PPS, then it's not actually going to charge quite as fast as Samsung's own charger. If you want to pick one of these up, I'll have a link in the description. Let's set the box aside and take a closer look at the Z Fold 3 itself. So there's a protective film on it with a pull tab, so let's go ahead and pull that. And that covers the entire device. And here's that Phantom Black color, which I absolutely love because it doesn't pick up fingerprints at all. Flipping over to the main screen on the Galaxy Fold 3 and comparing it to the Galaxy Fold 2, you can tell right away that the Galaxy Fold 3's screen feels much more like glass when you rub your finger across it than the Galaxy Fold 2 screen. This has almost like a rubbery texture, and there's a friction that's very noticeable when you try to run your finger across this that's very different than any glass screen I've used. So Samsung's done an excellent job at making the screen on the Fold 3 feel much more like glass. In terms of the hinge on the Fold 3 compared to the Fold 2, it does feel a bit more stiff. Like, it feels like it holds in different positions better than the Fold 2 does. And I don't know if that's because the hinge on the Fold 2 is a bit more worn out, since this has been my daily driver for a year now. But another notable improvement with the hinge is that opening it is a lot easier. Like, it takes a lot less force to start to open this than it does to start to open the Fold 2. The sides of the phones look very similar. You still have your fingerprint sensor and volume up and down buttons in the same positions, but the SIM card tray is now on top on the Fold 3, where it used to be on the bottom on the Fold 2. And the material that was used on the side is a bit less slippery on the Fold 3 compared to the Fold 2 as well, which does make it a bit easier to kind of grip and open. Here's a look at the backs of the devices. You can tell that the Fold 2 has a much more shiny, glossy finish. And I personally think the cameras on the Fold 3 look much better than the cameras on the Fold 2. And if you look closely, you can see that there's a lot of dirt that gets stuck in here around the camera. And that's really hard to get out. So I'm hoping that the new camera design is a little bit easier to clean. And the only other notable design difference is that the speaker grills on the Fold 3 are much larger than they were on the Fold 2 on both the top and the bottom. And one more thing, I did pick up a few cases for the Galaxy Z Fold 3. And if you want to see what I think about these cases, go ahead and subscribe and turn notifications so you don't miss the upload. All right, now it's time to set the device up. So the first thing we need to do is grab our old SIM card and put it in the new device. So to do that, just take your SIM ejector tool, push it in the SIM ejector pinhole to get your SIM tray to pop out, pull out the SIM tray, drop your SIM down, put that tray back in, then grab your Fold 3 and eject that tray. Put your SIM card in that tray, then slide the tray into the new device. Since my Z Fold 3 is an unlocked device, the phone's gonna have to restart after reading the SIM card so that I could set it up for my service provider. Just tap OK. Once your phone restarts, tap Start. Then agree to the terms and conditions as well as the privacy policy, but you don't need to agree to sending diagnostic data to Samsung. This doesn't send any personal information, but it does send data about how you use your device so that Samsung can improve their future devices. So it's up to you whether or not you want to share that data. Once you made your choice, tap Next. Then select your Wi-Fi network and sign into it. Once you're signed in, tap Next. And the next page I see is a copy apps and data option. However, if you have a carrier version of the device, like maybe an AT&T version or a T-Mobile version, then you may have to go through some more setup process before you get to this screen. If you see any options that say something like use AT&T's backup or Verizon's backup or something like that, don't do it. Skip those backup options until you get to this screen. Once you get here, tap Next. And since I do have my old device, I'm going to tap next again. Then it's going to update the Smart Switch application, and that's the application we're going to be using to transfer all the data from the old device to the new device. Next, select which type of device you're transferring from. Right now, I'm transferring from another Samsung device, but I'll show you guys what the setup process looks with both a non-Samsung Android device as well as an iPhone in a minute. For now, I'm just going to tap Galaxy. Tap Agree. You can transfer data with two methods, a cable method or a wireless method. The cable method's going to be the most robust option and likely the fastest option, but wireless is also pretty fast as well, so I'm just going to tap that. If your previous device is another Samsung device, you'll likely get a pop-up that asks you to connect to the new device, and if you tap yes, it'll let the Galaxy Z Fold 3 search through all the contents on your previous device and see what's available to bring over to the new device. Then you'll have to tap allow one more time. You'll see it start searching through all the data. Then it'll bring up a full list of everything that's available to transfer. If you don't get a pop-up on your old device, you'll just have to open up the Smart Switch application, tap Send Data, tap Wireless, then tap Allow. Now let's take a closer look at everything you can transfer. The first option is Accounts, and this will transfer your Samsung account as well as any Google accounts you're logged into. Even if you're logged into multiple Google accounts on the previous device, those will all transfer in one shot. You can also transfer all of your calls and contacts. You can also transfer all of your messages, and if you tap this arrow, you can choose to send all of your messages, just the last 2 years, last 1 year, last 6 months, last 3 months, or just the last 30 days worth of messages from the old device. Next, you can transfer all of your applications, and if you tap this arrow here, you can select which specific applications you'd like to transfer. Some applications won't transfer, like the calendar application, because when you sign into your Samsung calendar on the new device, it's automatically going to sync everything for you. An important thing to point out here is that if you have locked notes in Samsung Notes, you will have to unlock those notes first in order for them to transfer. Otherwise, those specific notes will not transfer to the new device. However, once you've transferred everything to the new device, you can just relock those notes. One major addition to Smart Switch is that you can now transfer WhatsApp messages that used to not be possible with Smart Switch, but now it is. And if you tap the letter I right here, you get more information on what you need to do in order to transfer all the messages from the old device to the new device. If you only want to transfer a few applications, you can tap this all icon up here that deselects everything. Then you can just select the few applications you want to transfer, or you can keep all selected and then just deselect the stuff that you don't want to transfer. The settings option is a really powerful transfer option because it allows you to transfer all of your Wi-Fi passwords and previous Bluetooth connections. The significance to that is that this means you don't have to re-log into Wi-Fi networks. And you can also deselect specific options like the phone settings and the app settings. Whenever I get a new device, I always like to start fresh, so I don't transfer those settings, but I do transfer the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth settings. The transfer home screen option lets you transfer your home screen setup from your old device to your new device, and this transfers everything from your widget layout to your app layout. It'll even transfer your lock screen wallpapers, your home screen wallpapers, and even Samsung DeX settings. You can also transfer all of your images and videos, and if you tap one of these arrows, you can transfer specific folders and specific images within each of those folders. And the same is true for all of your videos, your audio files, and even your documents and files folder. As you can see, if I select one of these other folders, I can see all of the different documents within that specific folder. Then deselect any specific documents I don't want to transfer. At the bottom, you get an option to see what can't be transferred. And if I tap that, you'll see that you can't transfer read-only contacts. You can't transfer calendar events from synced accounts because those transfer automatically anyway. As mentioned earlier, you can't transfer locked notes in Samsung Notes, so be sure to unlock those. WhatsApp chat history can't be transferred directly, but if you tap the little icon that I showed you guys earlier, that walks you through the transfer process. Certain apps also restrict transferring data from one device to another, so if you have one of those apps installed, that won't transfer. And the other thing that won't transfer are default wallpapers and Galaxy Themes wallpapers. And default wallpapers are just the wallpapers that come with the device. So if I was transferring from something like an iPhone, it wouldn't transfer those wallpapers over, likely for copyright reasons. Once you selected everything you want to transfer, you'll see how much data you're going to be transferring at the top, as well as the amount of time it's going to take to transfer all of that data. To save some time, I'm not going to transfer any of my images or videos, and you can see that the amount of data dropped substantially, and the time dropped to just 11 minutes. Now just tap transfer to start the process. If you're transferring from a non-Samsung Android device like this Pixel 5, you'll first need to download the Smart Switch application to that device. So open up the Play Store, search for Smart Switch, then go ahead and download and open that application. Then tap Let's Go to transfer your data. I'm going to go ahead and transfer wirelessly again. And as you can see, I can't transfer quite as much data as I could with the Samsung device. I can still transfer all of my accounts, all of my calls and contacts. I can still transfer all of my messages, but it's grayed out because I don't have any messages on this device right now. I recently factory reset it, so there's no messages to transfer. But if the messages were available, I'd still have the option to select how many of those messages I wanted to send, just like when transferring from a Samsung device. For the apps, I do get the option to select individual apps again as well. The settings also transfer, but as you can see, it only transfers the phone settings, so you don't get to transfer all of the Bluetooth or Wi-Fi connections. Images, videos, music, and documents do still give me the option to select specific folders and specific files within those folders. And that's about it for everything you can transfer from a non-Samsung Android device. Now let's see what you can transfer from an iPhone. The iPhone needs a cable to transfer data, so you'll need either a Lightning to USB-C cable or a Lightning to standard USB cable and a USB to USB-C adapter. If you need to pick up one of these adapters for yourself, I'll have links down in the description. Since I have the Lightning to USB-C cable, I'm just going to use that. Once the devices are plugged in, you'll get a pop-up asking you to trust the new device, so go ahead and tap Trust. Then enter in your passcode for your iPhone, then tap Next on the Fold 3. Then you'll get a new list of everything that you can transfer. As you can see, you still get the option to transfer a lot of different things, but you do have less options when transferring from an iPhone. Most notably, you're missing the accounts option. So if you're transferring from an iPhone, you won't be able to transfer any of your accounts over, even if you're logged into Google accounts on the iPhone. You can, however, transfer your calls and contacts. You can transfer your messages for the last 30 days, last 3 months, 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, or all of your messages. App transfers are a bit different when transferring from an iPhone because not every application available on the Apple App Store is going to be available on the Google Play Store. And if you tap this arrow, it tells you that if there isn't an Android version of a specific iOS application on your old device, you'll get recommendations of similar apps to install instead. You also get the option to transfer specific data from iPhone apps, but don't get too excited because it's only 4 applications. It's the calendar, notes app, any bookmarks you have in your Safari browser, and any alarms you have set up for your clock. The settings option does transfer your phone settings as well as Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. So you do get to transfer all of your Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connections when transferring from an iPhone. Even though you're transferring from an iPhone, you can still transfer your home screen setup. And this includes your apps and your shortcuts. In terms of images, videos, audio, and documents, you can still transfer all of that data as long as it's saved on the device. Any files that are stored only in your iCloud and are not stored specifically on your iPhone won't be transferred. And if you tap this option down here to find out what can't be transferred, you can see that there's some obvious things that don't transfer. Number one, you can't transfer FaceTime and voice call history. And messages with iMessage effects can't transfer because you can't have those effects on an Android device. And you also don't get emergency alert messages transferring. Similar to Samsung Notes, you can't transfer any locked notes here either. So if you want to transfer those notes to your new device, you do have to first unlock them on your iPhone. And while you can transfer your home screen layouts, you can't transfer your home screen wallpaper or your lock screen wallpaper when transferring from an iPhone. If you're going to be trading in your old device when you pick up your Galaxy Z Fold 3, and you won't actually have that old device to do this transfer, you can still use Smart Switch as long as you're transferring from an Android device. But instead of transferring directly to the new device, you'll be transferring everything onto a USB stick. To do this, you'll need either a USB-C type USB stick or a USB-C to standard USB adapter and a standard USB stick. Just plug the USB stick into your old device. In this case, I'll be plugging it into my Galaxy Z Fold 2. Then tap the SD card icon in the upper right corner. I'll tap USB storage because that's what's connected. Then I can go ahead and select all of the available items to transfer. And as you can see, I get all of the same options available as if I was transferring directly to the Galaxy Z Fold 3. Once the backup finishes, you can take out your USB stick and save it until you get your new device. Once you've received your new Fold 3, the setup process will be a bit different when using a USB stick. Instead of copying the data like we did before, you're going to click Don't Copy when you get to this page. From here, just continue to set up your phone and don't use any of the restore methods. Once your phone is set up but not restored, go ahead and open up the Samsung Smart Switch application. If it isn't installed, just go to the Google Play Store and download it. Once it's installed, open it up. And now you'll see that same SD card symbol in the top right corner. First, I'm going to go ahead and plug in my USB stick. Then I'll tap the icon, and you can see that I have 2 backups on this USB stick. If I tap to restore one of them, it'll show all the same restore options as the previous methods. One notable difference is that I can no longer select which specific applications or files I want to transfer, but that's not really a big deal because I already went through that process when I made the backup in the first place. From here, just tap restore and you're good to go. If you already set up your Fold 3 and didn't transfer any data, that's okay. All you have to do is go to your applications and open up the Samsung Smart Switch application, then tap receive data. Now just follow the same process I showed you earlier. And what's great about this is that it allows you to transfer data from multiple devices. So when you first set up your Fold 3, you can transfer all the data from your main device. But if you have a second device that's got a lot of information you'd like to transfer as well, just reopen the Smart Switch application and transfer those specific files. If you guys found this video helpful and want to help me out, go ahead and drop a like down below to help me beat the YouTube algorithm. And if you guys don't want to miss a ton of Galaxy Fold 3 coverage, be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss the uploads. That's it for this tech episode. God bless, guys, and I'll catch you in the next one.